Challenge: only use buffing towers. Bet: we're gonna be using the Engineer because it can buff with the Overclock, the Alchemist because it can buff with the Permanent Brew, and finally the Monkey Village because it can buff with the Homeland Defense. Also, Gwendolyn can buff with her level 10 and whatnot. And because of these towers, we can actually God Boost a Sentry Champion, which is exactly what we're gonna be doing. And as always, if you do enjoy, do not forget to drop a like, and if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe. And it looks like our opponent's hero is gonna be Fateweaver Adora, also known as Fedora. I have not used her, by the way, for so freaking long, bro, but we got the map down our graveyard. You guys know the strategy. I'm sorry too, I've been using Gwendolyn so much recently, but one, she's specifically really, really solid on this map, and two, in regards to today's challenge, she actually is a buffing hero technically. She buffs other heroes with her level 10 ability, and also with another thing that I can't remember off the top of my head, but she does definitely buff other towers, okay? So that's why I thought it would be super fitting to use her. Let's actually put her onto first as well so that we try to go no lives lost here. Okay, Sniper. Yeah, Druid Sniper. So he's gonna be able to regen his lives even if he happens to leak, which actually really, really sucks. I'm gonna go for the oversized nails upgrade here too as well. It's actually set you to strong maybe so that it pops a lot of those blue balloons for us because I don't think Gwen can fully pop all those. Yeah, okay. You know what? It's fine. It's not actually fine, but I'm gonna pretend that it is. We can still make this guy leak, but at the end of the day, he could always, always, always regen his lives. That's what really, really sucks here. But you know what? We're actually making these rounds like stalled out quite a bit, which is good for our sake because we are using a pure eco strategy. Or I shouldn't always, I don't know. I always say pure eco strategy. We do have sources of alt eco, but for the most part, I wanna focus mainly on our eco game with this one. He did go for the Druid of the Jungle as well, so he's going to be able to make some money with that. He's still just queuing up, by the way, red balloons. He does have a balloon bot set down, but you guys can't see it. It's behind my face cam, so I'm not too sure what his overall game plan is. Okay, he's going for those sniper upgrades. Round 5 is here. Intergroup greens now. Dude, I barely even upgraded this. Okay, I feel like I should upgrade this to a Sprockets and then possibly cross-path this with a pin. Got a tower boost out of him too, though, so we'll take that any day of the week. But yeah, with this challenge, guys, buffing towers only. The nice thing is that we're going to be able to go for a really, really buff tower. Now, specifically, I think the best upgrade to buff is going to be the Sentry Champion. So we're going to be able to overclock and ultra boost that. And on top of that, buff it with the Permanent Brew, as well as the Homeland Defense on the Village. So it's going to be one very, very strong Sentry Champion, that's for sure. So I'm excited for that. But it's not going to be easy to obtain that because all of like the max tier 5 buffing upgrades are not cheap by any means, ladies and gentlemen. So we got to make sure that we have enough money coming in left and right to afford that. Round 7 is here. Grouped yellows, it freaking is. Did he go for another Druid of the Jungle? Yes, I think he did. Now, he did also go for the Heart of Thunder on that one Druid. I guess he said, screw the increase of attack speed. Bro, if I just want a tower boosted, by the way, like earlier on to not leak there, I probably wouldn't have leaked. But like, I didn't want to waste a tower boost on that, dude. I swear, if that ends up biting me in the back, I'm going to be freaking so sad, dude. But round 8 is here. Okay, so Bathys Face Blacks. And ultimately, we want to upgrade this Engineer right here to a Sentry Expert. Bro is still sending me grouped reds. Like, I really don't get it. But at least he's getting money one way or another with those druids there, okay? You know what? I think we can even get away with this. Space Zebras here on round 9. Definitely over-ecoing here. But like I said, with this guy just still sending us grouped reds, he's not really pressuring us at the moment. So that's why I think we can greed here a little bit. Maybe I'll stop sending these, though, at the start of round 10 here. So now, into grouped reds, go for the Sentry Expert now, just so the Sentry Expert Sentry guns can actually start spawning in. If you go for this like too late or like the absolute last second, you still could technically die to like a purple rush or whatever kind of rush. Round 11. Okay, I think I'm gonna clear this obstacle here, and then I'm also going to go for right here a cleansing foam. Beautiful. Now we can target the cleansing foam in between these two paths right here, so it actually will affect both paths on both sides, which is super, super cool. Watch, you'll see with the camo green. Okay, well, there was already a cleansing foam there, but trust me, it does. But you first have to remove the obstacle, which costs $350. And then after that, you should be good. Round 13. Okay, yeah, I'm not gonna eco here, actually, because now we can go for a rubber to gold. We also could technically go for a balloon trap, but I don't think that's gonna be worth it in a situation like this. Okay. All right. That's fine, though. It missed, like, one pop there. I'm gonna straight go for the rubber to gold though, because he's gonna be sending me eco, of course. So if he wants to send me eco, he's gonna have to pay the price of generating us money with that rubber to gold there. So if he's sending us constant eco too, like, balloon traps don't make money off of your opponent's balloons, only AI balloons. So that's why I think in a situation like this, rubber to gold is gonna be a bit better than that balloon trap. Okay, but round 16 is here. Yeah, we're just gonna be max equaling with group black balloons throughout these mid-game rounds. I kind of wish I cross-packed this now with the middle path. Or actually, where should I have my Sentry Champion? Should I have it all the way up here? That might, I don't know, boys. I might want to have it down here. Because the Sentry Champion, like, once you cross-packed it with a middle path, its range is crazy, crazy good. So the Sentry Terrence will be able to, like, probably affect all the way up here. And then the hitboxes on 4-5 BEDs and whatnot are super large as well. Bro is going hard in the paint, though, with the Druid farms. My goodness, dude. So, again, although his eco is really, really low, at least he is gaining money with having all of those Druid of the jungles. It's actually I kind of helping him out with setting constant eco here. Technically, I probably shouldn't be, because the Druid of the jungles, in order for them to make $100 every 11 seconds, they need to actually be able to pop a balloon. So if I'm sending him constant balloons, then there's just more balloons for him to worry about and more potential for those Druid of the jungles to actually pop balloons. I know, I'm kind of yapping here, I'm sorry. Also gonna go for the supply drop. Brother is just going for everything but eco, dude. What in the world, man? Okay, but we're gonna transition into pink eco. Usually around the 1750 eco mark is when I like to transition into those, because now we can max the eco with pinks without running out of money, which is super, super nice. But, oh, okay, at least he's sending us pink eco too. So I'm actually then going to go for another one of these here, especially with these AI LEDs here. So yeah, let me put you on the last and then you on the close. Yeah, I think that might be a little bit better. Actually, maybe this one on close too. I don't know. It's like the alchemists, they kind of attack weird if you have them on last, so that's why I'm doing that. Okay, another rubber to gold here. Beautiful. I don't have pin on this. I guess I should go for pin, because this definitely did kind of push a little bit. Okay, round 20s here. Now, can we defend against this with our current setup? I mean, literally all we have is the Sentry freaking expert, and that's pretty much it, bro. So, oh shoot, I'm probably gonna have to use my level 10 ability here, unironically. Oh wait, and we gotta watch out for these camos, bro. We definitely gotta watch out for these camos. Okay, we're good there. We're good there. He tried. Gotta respect that. I'm gonna go with another one of those though, just so we have like better decamo. But also, I'm gonna start going for, actually all the way up here, a bottom path village. Now, this is gonna be a village farm, but also, mainly, we wanna go for the Monkeyopolis, because once we go for the Monkeyopolis, we'll get even more money from just simply ecoing, because before, the Monkey Town, once that was an upgrade, the Monkey Town is no longer an upgrade, but the Monkey Town, the Monkey City upgrades would give you more eco from simply ecoing. So like with me sending these group pinks right here, I would just be getting more eco per set of group pinks. But now that has changed to the Monkeyopolis, the tier 5. So it takes a little bit longer to get. Let's actually click right here and read it. Absorbs all monkey economy in Monkey City villages and their benefits, freeing up space for more monkeys. Balloon cents are worth 20% more income. So that's what I was talking about, okay? So 20% more income from Ecoing is pretty crazy, guys, okay? That's a big percentage right there. So obviously it's pretty hard to get earlier on. It's $15,000, a tier 5 upgrade, you know? So around round 24, round 25, I feel like it's pretty solid for sure. So we'll be able to get it up here probably after just one more income boost, because I don't want to like run out of money here. So yeah, I'm going to wait just one more. Go for that. Beautiful. Okay, so this could also technically absorb other monkey villages, but I'm not concerned about that. I'm more concerned about that 20% increase of income from ecoing. So yeah, but round 25 is here. I guess, bro, I'm going to have to go for like this or something, because I'm straight up struggling to the AI here. Kind of embarrassing, bro. I mean, surely we're fine against that, correct? Oh, no. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my God. Yo! No, he's a life advantage now. He doesn't even need to reach out his lives. Bro, that's so bad. Guys, that is so bad. Okay. We have actually got to watch out here, then. We actually have to. I'm probably... Okay, well, I have this now. Middle path is also able to do more damage than my class balloons, which is nice. Round 26 is here. Okay, pop this all down for me. Thank you. I'm gonna sell you. Oh gosh. Okay, wait, let's just sell you too. Cause it's gonna be hard to get that spot, you know? Okay. Go for the Century Champion. All right, beautiful. Now, at this point too, I probably should just go for a village here to buff the Century Champion, especially with the Jungle Drums. So there we go with that. Now, Century Champion, Century Guns too, cannot pop Purple Balloons. So I'm also gonna go for, on top of that, an MIB village to further buff it. And I think the next best thing for us to go for is gonna have to be the overclock. Now, I know I have like nothing going on, but like it's an all buffing strategy, bro. There's only so much that I can go for, you know? Okay, round 28, bro. This is probably gonna be, yeah, he's probably not gonna rush us, bro. He has not been aggressive this entire time. F's in the freaking chat, dude. But hey, we're still gonna continue on this game, no matter freaking what. Let's go for the overclock here. Beautiful. Okay, so now that we can overclock the Century Champion, bro, overclock slash Ultra Boost times the Century Champion, since the Ultra Boost just got buffed, or actually the overclock just got buffed, is crazy, because now when we overclock the Century Champion, not only does the tower itself get overclocked, but also every single Century Gun, bro. Every single one. That is insane. It makes the Century Champion so much better, bro. It's crazy. So we're definitely gonna have to make sure that we're constantly overclocking it, and we just get up the Ultra Boost in general. Maybe this is kind of a good thing, though, that we don't have the life advantage, because now he's like less likely to rush us, so he's gonna give us more time to obtain the upgrades that we need to go for, because we still need to go for the Ultra Boost. $100,000 for this upgrade here. We also need to go for the Permanent Brew. I would like to also go for the Alchemist Tier 5s and whatnot to help us out. Homeland Defense. Round 30 is in fact here, though. Should I stop ecoing now? I mean, he's still ecoing, so... Wow, we shredded that, though. We did, in fact, shred that. But I guess I won't stop ecoing if he's not stopping with the eco. Yeah, this is looking like a game, guys, to where we're going to have to rush him. And we're really, really just going to hope and pray that he counters. Okay, we'll take it all the way to round 39. I have no issues with that. It's just that now that he has that life advantage, and he always had that ace up his sleeve with being able to regen his lives anyway. But of course, the NGs, bro, they just leaked to that AI mob. Even with me using level 10, that was kind of crazy. But yeah, he was going to regen his lives no matter freaking what, in my opinion at least. But we're closing in on $100,000. Okay, so one more income tick, and then we'll go for that here. Come on, come on, come on. Go for that now. Beautiful. Okay, gets Ultra Boosted. Gets Ultra Boosted now. Again, every single one of these is going to be Ultra Boosted. The range on this, I guess, is not terrible, but it's not, like, as crazy as I thought. But, like, I wanted to initially do damage to the Fortify BADs and whatnot, you know? So that's kind of my thought process. Round 32 is here. Yeah, let's just continue on pushing up the eco. Just because why not? And although he has a lot going on over on his side, like, bro, his defense sucks. Like, straight up. He just has a lot of money-generating upgrades, so... He's definitely gonna have to be cautious here. Yo, wait, do I go for... Where do I go for this? I don't even freaking know, bro. I feel like right here, right about here or something, I should have my total transformation. So I'm going to have that. I always forget like which cross path is better, but we'll cross path you with the top path. And now that's able to transform, of course, 5 alchemists. So yeah, or actually we could go for NGs too. It's able to transform those. I don't know which one's technically better. I feel like Alchemist, just because like it's more money being put into the upgrade. I could totally be wrong about this. And I play this game every day. That's so bad that I don't know this, but I still don't know this. But I feel like it like matters with like how much money you're putting into the upgrade for when it actually transforms, you know? So like, for example, if you go for like 5,000 towers, then that wouldn't be as effective as if you were to upgrade those towers and then transform them, you know? So we'll go for these alchemists once again, though. Let's see the range on this. Okay, go for one more. I guess like down here. I know these placements aren't the best. Let's go ahead and Ultra Boost you. Already Ultra Boosted the times 5. Absolutely beautiful. I guess I can go for my Permanent Brew like more over here. I know it's not the greatest spot, but you actually cannot permanently buff or just buff in general any other alchemist. So like it doesn't really matter that we're not out buffing all of these down here. Ultra Boost does not need to be out buffed as well. Now what do we Ultra Boost though? The total transformation? I mean, I guess. Technically, I would like to like micro it, but I don't know, boys. He's still not rushing us, man. Yeah, he went for the Spirit of the Force. He was going to regen his lives no matter what. Oh, I'm so salty that I leaked, bro. I'm so salty. But yeah, definitely 8502 eco. More than enough for sure. We got max buffs on this besides the Homeland Defense. Let's continue on Ultra Boosting you as well. I'm going to have a Balloon Master Alchemist down here. Yeah, let me upgrade all of you. I guess to the Berserker Bruce of the 320s. Beautiful. This is level 20 as well. Oh, yeah, this is still set to first. Okay. I was going to leave it on first. I'm going to have all of these set to strong. I'm going to have... Oh, wait. I could have went for, at this point, though, I could have went for a triple XL trap. I'm sorry. Actually, no, I can't. I don't even have enough money. Okay, so I guess I'm not sorry about that. What? Oh, my... I'm going to have money to rush him, too, bro. I need money to rush him. That is actually crazy. Okay, so maybe I over-eco just a little bit, boys. Maybe, maybe, maybe. But we... Oh, my God. Man, we seem to need to go for the homeland defense. Oh, my gosh, bro. That's actually kind of crazy when you think about it. Okay, what even Ultra Boost next? We can't even Ultra Boost, by the way, the triple XL trap. Like, forever ago, they made it, like, to where the Ultra Boost does not affect the triple XL trap. Because if you have an Ultra Boosted triple XL trap in Battles 2, it is pretty insane. I can't lie to y'all. So, maybe that's for the better that that's not possible anymore. Okay, round 37 was actually super long there, though. So, I guess that's kind of good. I kind of want the MIB to, like, constantly be here. So, I guess I'm going to go for another village more up here. Go for the homeland defense. Okay, beautiful. Is this already Ultra Boosted times 5? Maybe it was, maybe it's not. I would also like to have overclocks. Because, like, look, although this is Ultra Boosted times 5, it does not have the overclock effect on it currently. So, we can, like, put the overclock effect on that still technically on top of the Ultra Boosting. So... yeah, I definitely want that. Okay, wait. I should have it more up here, though. It's a little bit cheaper inside the village's range. What do I Ultra Boost? BMA? I guess. I don't know. I literally have no idea, bro. Okay, we might have to sell the triple XL trap for about 40,000. Just so we can send him more balloons. Bro, like, again, he's got a lot going on. He can't defend, bro. He straight up cannot defend. So he's just going to have to counter here. Yeah, I want more money. Okay. Only one overclock then, it's fine. I'll leave the Ultra Boost. We don't need Ultra Boost this, so we'll leave it. Because, like, technically the Ultra Boost can still overclock this, so that's good. This could technically make us some money, but I want to send him as many fortified BEDs as I can, bro. As many as I can. So, let me sell you now. Okay. Hopefully he counters. Please counter me. Please counter me. Please, please, please. He's not going to counter me, is he? No, bro, I have max buffs on this. Come on, bro. I'm going to preemptively Ultra Boost you. Okay. No. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. I just used everything, though. Oh, my gosh. I was, like, stuck, bro. No. We're good? Oh, my gosh. He needs to die. I didn't even use TT. Oh, my gosh. I didn't even use TT, bro. Total transformation. Bro, I have max buffs on that, dude. I feel like it shouldn't even be close, dude. Holy crap. Yo, DDTs are crazy, man. Because of ramping, because the health and speed increases after every round, starting on, like, round 20 or something. So, a round 26 DDT is much slower and easier to defend against than a round 39 DDT. That's for sure. But... that's the all buffing strategy. I hope you guys still did enjoy. And if you haven't already, make sure to check out this video where we see if I can win with only 000 towers in Battles 2.